Dear students, good morning. Let's start our basic science class. Firstly, let's revise the points that we have studied in the previous classes. We studied about the reproductive organs of plants, that is flowers. The main parts of the flowers are calyx, corolla, androecium and gynoecium. Male reproductive part of a flower is androecium. And female reproductive part of a flower is gynoecium. Androecium produces pollen grains. Within it, male gamete is seen. Gynoecium produces ovules and inside it egg cells, which is the female gamete. The pollen grains from anthers falls on the stigma of gynoecium. This process is called pollination. After pollination, pollen grains develops through the style and reaches ovary, then fused with ovule. This process is called fertilization. There are three types of pollination, that is self-pollination, cross-pollination and artificial pollination. In self-pollination, pollen grains from a plant falls on the stigma of the same flower or the flower of the same plant. In cross-pollination, pollen grains from a plant falls on the stigma of the flower of another plant of same type. Whereas in artificial pollination, pollen grains from superior quality plants collected and dusted on the flower of other plants to produce high quality seeds. In artificial pollination, the self-pollination and cross-pollination of the plant is prevented. There are pollinating agents which helps the plants for pollination. There are of two types, that is biotic pollinating agents and abiotic agents. Biotic agents includes insects like butterfly, flies, beetles, honeybees, etc. And animals like bats, birds like hummingbird, etc. Abiotic factors includes dewdrops, water and wind. Here comes our activity number one. Complete this concept map of pollinating agents. Here is a concept map deals with the pollinating agents. The pollinating agents can be classified into two, that is abiotic and biotic. Abiotic agents includes insects, animals, birds. And abiotic factors includes dewdrops, water and wind. You should have to give examples for these. Okay, this is our activity number one. We know that male reproductive part is androecium and female reproductive part is gynoecium. When both androecium and gynoecium is present in a single flower, it is called bisexual flower. The example is hibiscus. When androecium and gynoecium found in separate flowers, it is called monosexual flowers, that is male flower and female flower is present. Examples are pumpkin, ash gourd, etc. Then we are studied about dioecious and monoecious plants. What is that? When male plant and female plant is different, it is called dioecious plants. That is male flower and female flower seen in different plants. Examples are nutmeg or jadhika, date palm or indapana, gambuj or kudambuli. There are a male plant and female plant are seen in different. It is called dioecious plants. When male flower and female flower seen in same plant, it is called monoecious plants. in watermelon, bitter gourd, snake gourd, male plant and male flower and female flower is seen in a same plant itself. This is called monoecious plants. So we studied up to this point. Now let's study how a fertilized flower became fruit. What will be the changes happen to the flower to become fruit? Let's observe these pictures of fruiting trees or flowering trees. Flowering plants, not trees, they are plants, shrubs or climbers, something like that. The first picture is lady's finger, or otherwise called okra. What are the changes happen to the lady's finger flower when it becomes the fruit, the lady's finger? Which are the parts of flower that is lost from a flower? We know that every part of the flower is not needed for a fruit. Okay, I think you have observed the picture very well. Now the next picture is a male and female flower of ash gourd. Which part resembles the fruit? Which part of the flower resembles seed? What will be happen to the male flower? Did you get the answers? Okay, next we have to observe the legume plant or yard beans, pyrogeny. Which part of the flower becomes fruit and seed? Do you observe well? Let's observe the flower of tomato plant. You can see the tomato plant, its flowers, and flowers becomes fruit. Which are the parts of flower still exist in fruit, and which are the parts that sheds or falls after the fruit formation? So in most of the plants, the fertilized ovules inside the ovary becomes the seed. The seed of the plant gives rise to next generation. The seed is the fertilized ovules inside the ovary. It will become a seed. Sepals also present in fruit. It gives support to the fruit. Then the thalamus or receptacle. It provides the seed for the fruit. Which are the floral parts that are not seen in fruit? Petals are withering or false. Petals, andrecium, stigma and style are not seen in fruits, right? So let's discuss which are the parts becomes the fruit. Firstly, the pedicel. Pedicel of flower becomes the stalk of fruit. It will be seen in fruit also. So pedicel becomes fruit stalk. Thalamus becomes the receptacle or seed for the fruit. Calyx becomes fruit calyx. It also supports the fruit. Corolla is absent. And ovary becomes the fruit. Ovary develops, swollen and becomes the fruit itself. The all fruit is the ovary. And the ovules becomes the seeds. There are seeds inside the fruit. Ovules becomes the seeds. So suppose in mango flower, the ovary of the mango flower becomes the mango. And the ovule inside the ovary becomes the seed inside the mango. Right. Mangandi. Mangandi is the seed of mango. Right. So pedicel becomes fruit stalk, thalamus becomes the receptacle for fruit, calyx becomes fruit calyx, ovary becomes fruit, and ovules becomes the seeds. Now let's go to the second activity, activity number 2. Complete the table in page number 26 of basic science textbook. Number 2, which part grows into seed? Number 3, which part grows into fruit? Okay, this is activity number 2. So now you may understand about the changes that happen to the flower when it becomes fruit. So you should observe the flowers that give rise to fruit, such as vegetables. Try to cut the flowers and observe the cross section and understand the arrangement of ovules in that flower. Compare it with the seed position in fruits. The arrangement of ovules will be same as that of arrangement of seeds in a fruit. You can found it correctly in lady's finger, brinjal. Okay, try to observe the cross section of ovary and the cross section of fruit. Okay, so this is enough for today. Rest in